Videos looking at variations on the prisoner's dilemma and coordination games in international relations. In this video, we're going to look at the variation known as Bach or Stravinsky, more commonly and unfortunately called sometimes the Battle of the Sexes. We look at the prisoner's dilemma itself, as well as other variations on the prisoner's dilemma in other videos, so you may want to watch those before watching this one. But if you're ready, let's get started with Bach or Stravinsky. The game is based on the following scenario. A couple want to go and see a concert, and there are two playing on the same evening. One person would rather see Bach, and the other would prefer to see Stravinsky. And importantly, they would like to see the concert together, even though each would rather see a different concert, and thus can't agree on which one they should go see. What should they do? When we represent our choices in a game theory model, we see the payouts listed here. Remember that the higher number means the happier each player is with the outcome. As we can see, there are two Nash equilibriums here, and both are Pareto optimal. As long as our couple wind up together at the same concert, they're happy they're at a Pareto optimal Nash equilibrium. Because of this, the Bach or Stravinsky game is known as a coordination game. Coordination games are situations in which there is a preferred outcome that can be reached through coordinated strategies. The primary obstacle is not the threat of defection because of competing incentives like it is in the prisoner's dilemma. Rather, it's simply finding a way to coordinate strategies and choices between the actors. The stag hunt, examined in another video, is also a coordination game. Coordination games like Bach or Stravinsky, as well as the stag hunt, have relevance in international relations in thinking, for example, about global regulatory regimes and standards. From the perspective of a company, having one set of standards, let's say metric or imperial, is preferable to having multiple standards differing across countries. But they generally don't have a preference as to which standards are better. Indeed, they'd be happy with either, provided they're used uniformly, as uniform standards could reduce operational expenses. And so in the absence of an international regulatory regime, independent actors may choose to coordinate their decisions in order to develop a common system that benefits them all. So that concludes our very brief overview of the Bach or Stravinsky game. Be sure to check out the other videos in this series which look at other variations in game theory, including the game of chicken and the volunteer's dilemma. Thanks for watching. Have a good day. Bye.